Sarah and Noel have changed the future. The proto-Falci that threatened academia is no more. And in the sky floats the 13th Ark. The people have built a society with their own hands, using technology of their own devising. However, the day when Cocoon is prophesied to fall is drawing closer. The Academy has put into motion an ambitious project to avert the catastrophe.
Be happy now.
This is what you wanted to see, wasn't it?
Welcome to the future, you say.
Are they real?
Now, is that a polite way to greet old friends? I mean, we haven't seen each other in what? How many years?
It's been all of 390 years. I guess you guys have been busy, huh?
Please come by my headquarters when you get a chance. You're guests of the Academy. Alyssa?
Later!
Hope told us that he invented a machine called a time capsule. That's how they got here. Back in 13 AF, Hope devised a plan to build an artificial Falci. It was called the Proto-Falci Project. He wanted to use the new technology to re-levitate Cocoon. But then one day, Hope saw a certain prophecy in the Oracle Drive.
So I activated the Oracle Drive and watched the prophecy. I saw you fighting the Proto-Falci, and I saw you screaming out at me. Your machines are driving me nuts!
Well, I was getting pretty ticked off by that point.
Well, exactly. So we were forced to reevaluate the project, and eventually abandon it.
Okay, you saw Sarah getting mad at you, so you canceled your project, and then poof, the Proto-Falci disappeared. Is that about right? We didn't destroy it so much as it never existed in the first place.
We were following the wrong path to the future. If the Proto-Falci had managed to get control of Cocoon, it would have made itself the second Eden, and we'd be back where we began.
Yeah. It would have been just like how it was on the old Cocoon.
We realized we couldn't let that happen. We had to levitate Cocoon using only human technology.
Right. Not to mention that if you had kept with the original plan, your machines would have killed you.
Really? Then we owe you our lives. Thank you.
Funny, you lose your temper and the whole future changes. So, I bet you're dying to know how we came to the future, huh?
Kinda.
You've heard about the time capsule we used? It's a device that slows down time only for its occupants. The effect is caused by the creation of a powerful gravitational field and, well, essentially we just slept as the outside world flashed forward into the future.
This capsule of yours, it can't take you back, can it?
Unfortunately not. And considering it broke down after a single use, I doubt it'll prove to be a popular method of time travel.
You risked your own life for the sake of Cocoon.
Oh, the director was there with me. Hey, Sarah. After coming to the future myself, I think I understand how you must feel. The Academy has welcomed us with open arms, and we can research as we always have, but sometimes, I get these terrible anxiety attacks.
Alyssa,
please, Sarah, you have to let me apologize for the way I treated you in the past. Maybe you can't forgive me for that, but I hope as fellow time travelers, we can face the future on friendly terms. Academy has made progress on its investigation into the 13th Arc. At this stage, there is good news and there is bad news.
Let's hear the good news first.
We've discovered that the Arc's reactor is powered by an ore cluster, known as the Graviton Core. By collecting these, there's a possibility that the new cocoon will be up in the sky in no time.
That is good news.
Yeah, okay. So now you gotta hit us with the bad news.
Each ore cluster provides only a certain amount of power. The 13th Arc, for example, requires a single Graviton core. We're going to need multiple cores that we can't seem to find.
Need a hand with the search?
If there's one thing we're good at, it's looking for weird objects.
We could use the help. With you two on the case, we'll have those cores in no time.
I'll put together some data on Graviton cores. Check in with the Academy front desk. If you don't mind, I'll just take a sliver for my research. Did I tell you? The Director is inventing a new device.
The Academy has been making progress on the development of a paradox weapon. A very powerful weapon that feeds on time-distorting energies.
Using a paradox against itself, huh?
Exactly. There's a possibility we may come up against the man who appears in the Oracle Drive recordings. The war has already begun, and we're fighting to protect the future itself.
A battle to the end against Caius.
But, Director, didn't you say you were missing a certain material?
A Chaos Crystal. It's a solidified chunk of Paradox energy, but according to the data, it doesn't exist in this time period.
Well, hey, you've still got us.
And we've got the Historia Crux.
I knew I could count on you. Once you've found the crystal, I can build you a prototype.
The technology to raise the new cocoon into the sky is already there. As soon as we have all the Graviton cores, we'll have the power source we need.